من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر حتى مطلع الفجر صدق الله العظيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. الحمد لله, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's been a beautiful month of Ramadan, alhamdulillah. And as we mentioned, we keep on seeing the month Ramadan again and again. And not only although this is specifically for Laylatul Qadr and the importance of it and how to look out for Laylatul Qadr, but it comes throughout the month of Ramadan. The entire month of Ramadan, it's a month that we have to really look up to, and our ibadat has to increase. So as we know, we have three phases throughout the month of Ramadan, where you have Nabi Sallam said, وَهُوَ شَهْرٌ أَوَّلُهُ رَحْمَةٌ, the first 10 days of it is Allah's mercy, وَأَوْسَطُهُ مَغْفِرَةٌ, the middle 10 days of it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness, and the last 10 days of it is emancipation, وَأَخِرُ عِتْقٌ مِنَ النَّارِ, emancipation from the fire of Jahannam. So at the same time, in that very hadith, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when the month of Ramadan approached, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam addressed the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. A very lengthy hadith, but in there Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is speaking to the Sahaba and telling them about the importance of Ramadan and the virtues and the rewards that people that we can get as believers in this Mubarak month of Ramadan is. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, and in the month of Ramadan there is a night. There is a night that if a person finds that night, this night khayrun min alfi shahrin ibadah, and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this particular night, it's better than 1,000 months. Can we even imagine 1,000 months? Now, just to keep you, to put you through this, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he was shown about the Umar and the age of his Ummah, of his followers, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, how can my Ummah do so much of ibadat in this time, in this minimal time that they have, the 60 or 70 years, whatever in that middle. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to condole, as a means of condolences to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, gave him this night, this powerful night, inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, indeed we've revealed it. What Quran? The Quran. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says that the Quran first, it came to the lowest heaven in a place where it's called Baytul Izzah, the house of honor, and then after that gradually it came down within the space of 23 years as it was needed. It revealed, it came down to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So it's a night that we look up to. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, iltamisuha fil ashril awakhir min Ramadan. So the second part is how to look, or when is Laylatul Qadr? Very important. So we look at Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan. So if today is the 20th of Ramadan, after the sun set, the Laylatul Qadr, from that particular day, we start looking out for Laylatul Qadr. And so it mostly happens, as well as Nabi Sallam said, look at it in the odd nights, which is the 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th and 29th. Most favorably, they say that is the 27th night where it happens, although it's not a belief that it has to happen on that particular night, but it might happen on that. But we have to look out for it throughout the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan. Very importantly is to note that towards the end of the night, that's the best time of Laylatul Qadr. And that happens throughout the year. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, إِنَّ فِي اللَّيْلِ سَاعَةً, that in night there is this hour, لَا يُوَفِقُهَا عَبْدٌ مُؤْمِنٌ, that a believer would not find this hour. And in this hour, he supplicates to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. He asks Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala for forgiveness, for goodness, for maghfirah, for rahmah, mercy, blessings, whatever. Whatever he asks Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala in that particular night, towards the end of the night, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala will respond to his dua. So respect the elders and brothers in Islam, the youth out there as well. We know that the 27th night, it's going to be the finals, I believe. And on that particular night, at the same time where it might be the Laylatul Qadr, we are being tested to see that where are we going to go now? Are we going to go watch the finals, or are we going to go and make the ibadat? And we've seen that, mashallah, in various masajid, perhaps there are programs on that particular night. So let us go for the programs. Let us seize this opportunity, because this kind of opportunities don't just come all the time. There are many people that you and I knew personally that were there with us just prior to the month of Ramadan. They left this world already. So life doesn't have any guarantee that we're going to live up to the next month of Ramadan. Are we going to have again time to look out for the Laylatul Qadr? No. So this one, as long as we are alive, inshallah, let us try to our best ability. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned beautifully that the night of Qadr, Laylatun Samh, it's a gentle night. It's a gentle night. La har wa la barid. It's not cold. It's not hot. It's in the middle, and Nabi Sallam says, "Tusbihu shamsu sabihataha da'ifa." That in the morning of Laylatul Qadr, in that morning, the sun raises weak, meaning it doesn't have rays on it, hamra, and it has a reddish color on it. So these are other signs of Laylatul Qadr as well, that a person can come to know that it was Laylatul Qadr last night or it wasn't. So inshallah, and throughout the month of Ramadan, as I mentioned earlier, that the virtues are so many. So you and I have to take this opportunity, have to seize this opportunity and make ibadah and make. Remember, we're in a month where a person that does an optional ibadah, he's rewarded as if he's done an obligation. If a person does a fard ibadah, as if he's done 70 faraid in any other months out of the month of Ramadan. So let us just not let it just go out like that, but rather let us seize this opportunity. You know, on a lighter note, before we complete, our Ustaz mentioned to us that once a person came, this Maulana came, and he said to this Hazrat Ji, he said, "Hazrat, I've got one problem, man." So he says to him, "What?" So he said, "Log meri qadar nahi karte hain. Log meri qadar nahi karte hain. People don't appreciate me. People don't appreciate me." So the Hazrat said to him, he laughed and he looked at him. He said to him, "Log Laylatul Qadr ki qadar nahi karte hain. Tera qadar kahan karenge?" People don't even appreciate the night of appreciation, the night of Qadr, the night of power, the night of value. Where will they appreciate you? So inshallah, let us be among those that it's a night, and the fada'il and the virtues and the rewards are so many. So let us seize this opportunity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me, firstly, all of us ability to engage ourselves in ibadah on that particular night. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us with iman, take us away with iman, resurrect us on the day of qiyamah with the pious with iman. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.